Okay. So what I need from you, first some of the, well, I can look up the background. I can get the background from the internet. So you said you had three stories where...
There's a few stories, yeah. There's a story about one of the owners years ago, and I've owned the restaurant about 10 years. So most of my stories are hearsay. But some things have happened since I've been here. And I actually had one experience myself where I was in the dining room on a Saturday when no one else was here, and I heard someone yell hello from the back. And
yelled
hello from the back of the restaurant. I heard it clear as could be. And when I got back there, there was nobody there. All the doors were still locked. And so that was kind of weird. That was my own personal experience with that.
And nobody was here.
Nobody else was here, and all the doors were still locked. So
was it a male voice?
It did seem like a male voice, but it's hard to know. It's been a long time now, so I can't tell you, but that was kind of an unusual situation. One of the previous owners was sitting at the bar one night, and he saw this lady in the red dress right here walk behind him. He's in the mirror. He saw her walk behind him, and when he turned around, nobody was there, and that was it for him. He was up. He was out. He locked the doors and said, I'm going home for the night. Now.
Oh, but did he quit?
No.
Okay.
No, he was an owner, so he owned the place. He was couldn't really quit. But the paranormal people that came in said that makes sense because she wasn't behind him. She was in the mirror. So that's why he saw her in the mirror. She's in the mirror. She never walked behind him. She was always in the mirror. So when he turned around, that's why he didn't see her behind him. So... kind of an interesting take on that.
Yeah, they say that mirrors capture spirits and all that, and that's why she didn't manifest in real life, but in the mirror.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Was she kind of see-through or solid?
I think she was solid. He said he thought it was a woman in a red dress that just walked behind him, and he didn't know there was anybody else in the bar then because it was after business, and he was just sitting there by himself.
Okay. He was scared? Okay.
Yep.
What was his name?
Tom. Tom was the previous owner. We also had a couple of kitchen employees that one person one night, a dishwasher, felt someone put their hand on his shoulder, and when he turned around, he was by himself. And so that freaked him out. He may have quit. I know he left, and other people had to do the rest of his work that night. And then other people in the kitchen, another dishwasher, had somebody say something to him when he was the only one back there in the kitchen as well. And that totally freaked him out.
And the dishwasher's name?
I'm not sure. It's been so long, and we go through them very quickly. So it's hard to know. Hard to know who that person was years ago. And it was one of them was before my... Both of them, I think, were before my time.
So... are those all the stories?
There's some stuff in here that they found, little things. Those are the main stories I have. The two dishwashers, the owner at the bar, my own personal story.
Okay.
This talks about Della Tovery. Della lived in the castle across the street and was one of the Tovery wives, and that's a lot of people think that Della is the one that strolls around here, so... I have more other stories. Maybe the night cleaners, past night cleaners. I had one crew refuse to come back in and work anymore because they saw someone crouched behind the trash can in the corner of the bar. They swear they saw a person crouched and hiding over there, and there's no human being in the building with them. So, not sure what that was. But the night crews. I've had a couple of different night crews that have been very scared because of things they've heard and seen and over the years.
What time do you guys close?
Everybody's usually out of the building no later than 11, typically. So a lot of these things have happened after 11 o'clock.
Okay. Have you, like out of curiosity, come back, because I'm assuming you have the keys, have you ever come back here intentionally all by yourself at night just to see what happens?
No.
You don't want to? Why not? You have such a big opportunity to do it.
No, I have never done that. Yeah, my life is scary enough, Amy, without that.
Okay.